I'm Dennis Gage, and welcome to My Classic Car. Well, this week we're in Ridgely, Maryland for their annual car show. This is a nice, sleepy little town that really comes alive one day out of the year. They got 600 or 700 pre-registered here. I don't even know how many cars there are. Let's get around and check some of these babies out. Check it out, three in the tree. Hey, Brenda, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you, Dennis?
I'm good. You know, I'd say you've done it again.
I think so. 9 years. Nine years. Who knew we would be this far?
But it's been a blast. So you started out with about 100 cars, right?
About 103 cars, yeah.
Wow.
And every year it just grows.
So what's the count? What do you think?
We're thinking around 925, but yeah, I think it's a little more, but we won't know till the numbers come in. And, you know, we always have the king. We have the wonderful, beautiful Linda Vaughn.
I love this man.
She's so beautiful. I just love this lady. Timeless beauty.
Exactly. So, you know, and I don't know how many people we have, but we got a lot of people here.
Yeah, I talked to people pretty much from all up and down the East Coast. You know, some for the first time,
yes,
digging it.
Yes.
And some that, no, man, I come every year. It's just too cool. Yep. I can't pass it up.
Yeah. Yeah, we've had people, I mean, all the way from Canada, some people from Florida, California. I mean, it has just grown, and you just can't ask for a better bunch of people.
And you know, you've got quite an accumulation of Mopars here. You're sort of a bunch of Mopar heads.
I'm a Mopar girl.
You're a Mopar girl, yes you are. And quite a few Superbirds over there.
That was pretty impressive.
And of course, since Linda Vaughn's here, you got a lot of hearse cars.
We do.
Oh my gosh.
So yeah, it's amazing.
Yeah, it's cool. It's a lot of fun too, and everybody seems to be having a good time. It's a beautiful day, and there's some killer cars here. What do you say we go look at a few of them?
That sounds good.
All right, let's do it. Thank you. Well, Joy, this is really cool. This is a 70 AAR CUDA, and I've never seen one this color. What do they call this?
This is lime green metallic.
Which is a really weird name for this color, because it's not lime green.
Right.
It's kind of, maybe it's the outside of a lime.
Yep, right.
But it's not what I think of as lime green.
Right,
I think
right.
of sublime as
right,
more
right,
like lime green.
Right.
This looks like the real deal, and I think the giveaway is the fact that the hood is bowed.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, right.
Because they're fiberglass hoods and they all did that.
Right, they all did it. That's how you know they're real.
That's a real one.
That's right. It doesn't fit right. That's right.
And the doors probably sag a little bit too.
Yep.
You know it's real.
Exactly.
I mean, this is your car.
Right. My dad said from my 6 years old, I've always been into muscle cars. Mopar was my
dream. That was your mark, right?
Yep, that was it.
The other thing that I like about this car is it's green, but I mean, it's really green.
Right,
You've got the green interior too, right?
Right, yeah.
Now, was that restored or is that the original upholstery?
Restored.
It has been restored, but probably factory color.
Yes, wow. All numbers matching.
Wow, and nothing says Mopar like a pistol grip shifter.
That's right. I have to have it.
You know, the dash is in great shape too. Of course, it's probably, that might've been something they redid too, because they cracked a lot back in the day. It looks just completely original, though. This is a really nice job on it.
So it's 17-year restoration.
It was 17 years ago.
Yeah, man, it's held
up really well. Yeah. And I believe this was a collapsible steering wheel. It was one of the first ones. That's what that ribbing is. With the AAR CUDA.
Mm-hmm.
So that's probably, when they redid it, they probably redid the striping and everything, too. And I love your license plate, CUDA girl.
How did
you get that?
As soon as I got this car, I did the deal. And as soon as I left, everyone said, she's the CUDA girl. I actually have it tattooed on the back of my neck.
My golly, you do.
I do.
You weren't lying to me.
No. They call me the CUDA girl.
You are the CUDA girl.
Yeah.
Well, these things were, you know, I mean, AAR, it's a 340.
Yeah.
So let's go look at that baby.
Okay.
Oh, that's right. There's no real latch. It's just the hood pins.
Right. Okay. There you go.
So, and it's a 340 six barrel.
Yes.
Not a six pack.
Right, six barrel for Plymouth.
Six barrel because it's Plymouth.
Right.
Body color, engine bay, that's totally Mopar.
Yep.
Orange as orange can be.
Yes, orange can be.
I mean, was that also 17 years ago that they made it look like that?
We've done some things to it.
Yeah, just kind of.
But pretty stock.
Wow.
Yeah, pretty stock.
Well, you know, you don't need to do
much.
These
right.
are fast as all get out.
It's exactly.
And personally, I've always preferred this to the big block. I think it revs higher, brakes less, and it's not as heavy up front, so I think they steer better.
Yeah, this is the non-power steering car.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh.
Have you seen me park?
Well, you know, that wasn't that uncommon back then.
I know,
you know?
And I don't want to change it. I want to keep it that way.
No, I agree. I think that's cool.
I want to keep it that way.
Well, it's not like it's a daily driver either.
No,
you know, so you can take it. Plus, it builds up the muscles.
That's right, staying at the gym.
Wow, this is beautiful, 1970 AAR CUDA.
Yep.
in lime green, metallic.
Yep. Metallic.
Right?
Yep.
Owned by the CUDA girl herself. Joy, thanks for bringing this out.
Thank you so much.
Beautiful car.
Thank you.
Well, Tony, you know, ambulances are kind of interesting vehicles to begin with. I think of them as, you know, built in Caddies or Buicks. This is a 64 Pontiac, right?
Yes, it is.
Started as a Bonneville?
It did. They sent them out to Superior Coach, and basically they chopped the roof off of the Bonneville and fabricated a roof. The emergency lights are custom. The cabinetry is custom. They're almost not identical to any other type of ambulance, just because of that simple fact of the customization. Now everything's kind of a cookie cutter.
Yeah. Was it converted in 64?
Yes, it was. The fire company would have bought the Bonneville as the station wagon, and off it would have went to Superior Coach. Chop, chop, cut, cut.
Poof, it's an ambulance.
There you go.
Is it original paint or not?
So the white is original. The red was redone.
The interior is original, but is it Pontiac or not?
I would assume.
Well, you know, there's no change to the dash, really. And it still says Bonneville over there with a grab bar. And, you know, and then, yes, it's an ambulance. You've got everything, don't you?
We have everything. She's fully equipped to period correct equipment.
Did you buy this with it, or did you have to find all this?
No, I spent a few years collecting bits and pieces here and there.
It's actually pretty fancy. The whole thing's done red and white all the way through the back, even though it's an ambulance.
It really is. Before, when I said that they were, you know, there's not really one as the same, because everything was customizable back then.
It's interesting. They bumped this top up high enough that a EMT could sit back there, actually.
That's correct.
Do you take this to a lot of shows?
I do. I try to get out to as many shows as I can. Always gets a very warm welcome. People that are around in the 60s often refer to the Kennedy ambulance, which was also a 64.
Oh, was it a Bonneville?
It was.
Oh, I didn't know that.
That was a military version. Oh, and the interesting thing about the military version was the top of the unit was steel, not fiberglass.
Okay. Oh, so this is all fiberglass.
This is all fiberglass.
And these are like monster 59 caddy tail lights. I mean, they're monster,
they are
though.
Something else.
Are they off of anything, or do they make them specifically for this?
No, they actually, if you look really close, they are actually stamped Superior Coach.
Oh my gosh, they are. It was a fancy ambulance.
They were in their time.
They're going to go to the hospital. You may as well ride in style, huh?
Hey, why not?
Close that back up, and let's go see what you got under the hood and see if it's, in fact, Pontiac through and through.
All right.
Well, that's Pontiac, right? 389?
389.
Yeah, it looks like you drive this thing.
I do. I drive it every show I go to. Some interesting features with the ambulance is, of course, the relays and the monster alternator.
That is huge.
To power everything.
And what are all, I mean, these are all
those
solenoids?
Those are all solenoids, relays for the lights, for the siren, which is a mechanical, you know, it spins.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, this is very cool. 1964 Superior Coach converted Pontiac Bonneville ambulance. How cool is that? Thanks, Tony.
Pleasure.
Well, Rick, this is a tall Ranger. This is the tallest Ranger I think I've ever seen. This is what, an 1983?
1983.
83 Ford Ranger.
Ford Ranger.
So now, Ranger was Ford's little truck, right?
Yes, sir.
But you made it bigger.
Made it bigger.
Made it much
first
bigger.
First year for what they called the mid-size truck.
Uh-huh. So this was a work truck for you?
My work truck. It was orange when I bought it. Went to put a V8 into it. One thing led to another, and before you know it, it was a bare frame on the ground.
You know, it throws you off a little bit because it does look GM, actually, with that hood.
Correct.
It kind of does. But it's a Ford.
But it's all Ford.
It's all Ford. So, I mean, you've lifted a long way. What did you do?
5-inch suspension, 3-inch body, and then the fender cutouts give you extra room for a little bit more tires.
Yeah, and speaking of tires, those are pretty beefy.
Yeah, 37-inch creepy crawlers.
So, and is it a 4x4?
4x4, 9-inch Ford rear, 456 gears, Detroit locker.
Wow.
Yeah, she rolls.
Yeah, she does. Well, now it looks so nice, and it's not a work truck anymore, obviously. But do you use it, or is it a show?
We use it for riding around. I've put about 5,000 miles, I guess, on it since we redid it.
Interior-wise, too, you basically...
kind of gutted it and kept with the same theme, tried to keep a Ford approachable look. Everything that is orange now used to be black, and everything that's black used to be tan. So I did the Ford gauges, the automotive gauges, and
what are your gauges down there on the floor?
That's my transmission and my boost for the blower.
Of course, it's blown. Of course, yeah. Again, I mean, if you use this thing for a work truck, you straighten this out.
Yeah,
you did some serious
straightening. Actually, the bed is
It's a newer bed that I got off of another truck. Sanded and sanded for hours and days to get everything, you know, to keep it that factory look like how we can do it. Oh, it is,
and it paints really good. She's really straight.
This is kind of cool. You got a little Halloween thing going on.
A little Halloween thing, and, you know, just a little bit. I wanted the letters to pop, but not pop the letter, so.
I think you achieved that.
Yeah.
Is that actually your plate?
That's my plate.
You were able to get Bad Ford?
Bad Ford.
You are a lucky man.
Yeah.
So you're talking about this blown engine up there. Let's go have a look at
it. Yeah.
Wow. Okay, so what are we looking at?
It's a 302 stroked out to a 347. It's got the 174 Holley blower, 850 quick fuel carburetor, Vic Senior heads onto it. I did the dual batteries, I did the dual oil filter, so anything I could dual it. I did tractor trailer size battery wires everywhere I went, so painted all the boxes black and, you know, tried to pop all that back out of it. L&L headers onto it. I had to cut the blower down to make all of it fit with the serpentine because I didn't want to move the radiator or nothing, so.
You got the Great Pumpkin theme still going.
Yeah, the Great Pumpkin theme. Mm-hmm. I told the guy, I said, I don't want a cartoonish Great Pumpkin, I want the spookiest, and the guy looked at it, he said, it'll be sinister.
You know, I'm not a real airbrush guy, but this is a nice job.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. When you shut it up, everybody likes how clean the truck looks from the overall outside, and that's why with the tailgate, I didn't want to get
too crazy
or anything like that.
So, 1983 Ford Ranger that's living the lifted life.
Living the lifted life, yes, sir.
Thanks for bringing it up,
thanks,
man.
Thanks, Mr. Dennis.
Wow, cool. Bill, this is a pretty sweet car here. This is a 67 Galaxie 500 convertible, 428 from the factory?
Yes.
Man, you don't see these very often. I don't even know why. You'll see the 67s, but you don't see the convertibles very often at all. Do you run into one at other shows?
I haven't seen one yet at another show.
Really, so you're like the only kid on the block, right?
Yes, yes, I am.
And this has been in the family, right?
Yes, it has. I remember riding it as I was a kid.
No kidding. It's a mild resto mod, basically,
yes,
right?
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. So what all you done?
I had some friends of mine. I have a friend of mine, he paints.
Yeah.
He came over to the house. This is his garage, paint job, body work. He did it there. Friends of mine.
Like just in the garage at home?
Yes.
Oh, mm-hmm. Cool.
In the garage at home, yeah.
You know, the chrome looks good.
The bumpers are original, but I had taken them off and had them redipped.
Oh, you do?
Yeah,
you did?
I did have bumpers redipped, yes. Cool. Yes.
And you're sporting some interesting wheels. What are you, 17s in front or what are
they? Yeah, 17s in front, 20s in the back.
Oh, uh-huh. Yeah. That's a good look.
Yes.
I like the interior. Is that kind of original pattern?
This is kind of customized. Like I said, a friend of mine, he does interior work, and I told him what colors I was going to make the car, and I basically took his decision.
Well, how about those console gauges? Were they there?
The console gauges wasn't there. They came with lights there. I was a little bit scared of the lights, so I'd say I'm gonna put some gauges back there.
I like knowing what's going on.
Yes.
You know, I like that. I'm a fan of that. Updated radio, did it have an 8-track back in the day?
It didn't have an 8-track, but I do have the original radio.
Did your buddy redo the door skins, or is that original?
The door skins are new, out of the box, you know.
Okay,
the original colors, you know.
She looks really nice, though, really straight. I mean, was it in good shape when you guys started on it, or did you have to straighten it out a bit?
I had to straighten one quarter a bit, because the quarters on this car was hard to find.
Which one was it?
That's this one.
I can't tell. I can't tell. I always like the taillights on these. From a distance, I don't know that. Some about those, I just think they look really good.
Thank you.
I mean, the thing, again, you don't see them. I actually love the black and silver combo. She looks just great. And, you know, the real mild resto mod.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go up and look at that 428.
Okay, sure.
Oh, wow. That's not just a 428. That's a fancy 428.
It's basically stock 428.
But just dressed it up a little.
Dressed up a little, yeah. But it just has a little mild camshaft in it, you know, for cooling purposes. But other than that, you know, the original 428.
What's the carburetor? That's a polished aluminum?
Oh, that's a 750 Holley.
Uh-huh. Is it a driver or is it a show car?
It's both.
It's both.
Both, yeah. I can drive it just about. I mean, the car go all over the place.
Solid.
Delaware, Atlantic City. I mean, I just get it in and just go.
Do you go top down?
Very rare. My friends get on me a lot because I think they only seen this car maybe three times with the top down.
You know, I tell you, I caught my eye with the top up, and I'm not sure it would have with the top down. That black just sets it off so much, I think. 1967 Galaxie 500 428 from the factory, worked over
by Bill and his buddies. Thanks for bringing it out, man.
Thank you.
All right.
Well, Dick, this is a cute little 31 Chevy pickup. I guess a pickup?
Yes.
This has been kind of redone, rebodied by Hercules back in the day. And Hercules was based in Evansville, Indiana, which is where I'm from.
I didn't know that.
That is true. That is true. So what's the story on this? Did you buy it this way?
I found it in a barn.
Yeah.
The bed was filled up with beer cans and chicken feathers and decided to hot rod it. And now it has TCI front end, a 355 Chevy V8 automatic, air conditioning, Richmond quick change rear.
All the comforts of home,
all
right?
All the comforts of home, yes.
So what are the wheels? Because they're kind of a Bonneville style?
Actually, no. I use the original 31 Chevy grease caps.
Okay.
That little dish comes off. Uh-huh. Lug nuts are behind the dish.
Oh, my gosh.
The original wheels on the truck were metal dish wheels held on with four clips, but they were only 4-inch wide tires. So I like that detail, and I kept it, and you'll never see them again.
They're under there. You just can't see them. Is that an aftermarket grill, or do you...
It is an aftermarket grill. It's a 32 Chevy grill. Actually, the original truck did not have a grill. It had a honeycomb radiator.
Man, that's really cool. Now, have you done any modification on the body, or is this what it was?
No, this is original 1931 as it came out of the factory.
Because, I mean, it's really quite tall.
The hot rod shop wanted to chop it. I said, no deal.
Don't chop it.
Don't chop it.
Gauge-wise, was that the layout? But there's a lot more gauges than in 31.
That was absolutely the layout.
Oh, really? And, you know, kind of a nice interior, this
leather
sort of
suede
distressed leather. Yeah, very nice. And did you use the original seat frame or not?
The original seats had two little
platforms. Yes.
And the gas tank was under the seat.
That's always comforting, isn't it?
Yes, it is. We moved it to the back.
I think that's a good idea. And so your gas tank is this?
That's 10 gallons of gas, and I go as far as it'll take me.
So these rode kind of like a buckboard. Is it better now?
At 70 miles an hour, it just purrs down the road. You'd think the wind would blow it around.
It doesn't, huh?
Just as solid
as
it can
be. Well, this is pretty serious tires back here. These are like 22s or something?
18 by 8s in the front, 20 by 10s in the rear. The bed is original. This is old Georgia hard pine, and we put an automotive clear coat on it.
Wow, that's really nice. And you say she's got a quick change. It's not a Winners, it's a what?
Well, it's a Richmond. I think Richmond kind of stole
the
Winners stuff. Because if I go to Winners and want to buy parts, they won't sell me parts, but they're all interchangeable.
Well, let's go have a look at the engine. What do you say?
All right, cool.
Oh, is that the original hood, too?
Yes.
Wow, that's really neat. So 355, dual quad. And you got a few knuckles in
there. Everything's tight.
Yeah, it's real tight. It's real tight. Is that the original firewall, or would they have
to
move it back?
No, we didn't do anything to the firewall.
Man, you shoehorned that thing in there.
We pulled the frame off, boxed the frame. It's the original frame. Like I say, all the panels are original. It's as original a body as you'll ever see.
But not so much the engine.
Not so much the engine.
Closer back up. This really is cool. And I think one of the things that makes it for me, I love the height. So I love that you didn't chop it. And I really dig your wheels. I think that's so cool, man. So 31, right? 31 Chevy bodied by Hercules out of Evansville, Indiana. I dig your truck. Thanks for bringing
it out,
man.
Thank you very much. Well, thanks for the interview.
Hey, we had a great time at the Ridgely Car Show. Little town, big show. You might want to check this one out.